More than 800 people with one mission, promoting a healthy environment. We are the West Virginia Department of Environmental Protection.
It's home to nearly 800 6th, 7th, and 8th grade students and is projected to be the first LEED Silver certified middle school in the state. Huntington East Middle School was completed this past fall and welcomed its first students in January. The DEP's Sarah Alford joins us now. And Sarah, what goes into making this school building so special?
Greg, first of all, it's a beautiful facility, state of the art, from its heat-reflecting white rubber roof to its low-maintenance polished concrete floors. But that's just the half of it.
3, 2, 1.
It was a day of celebration, cutting the ribbon on the new Huntington East Middle. The school is a consolidation of Enslow and Beverly Hills Middle Schools. Teachers and staff moved into the 100,000 square foot facility over Christmas break. The building is light and airy with lots of windows for natural light. The school features online learning and technology systems throughout the facility and is designed with energy efficiency and sustainability principles in mind.
The purpose is to educate the children as well as make a building that is environmentally friendly and saves the county money as well as services.
And the learning won't be limited to just the classroom.
We plan on doing a lot of different things. Each science wing, as soon as weather permits, are going to have their own raised bed garden. We also have purchased a greenhouse that we're going to install.
The school also features an advanced pulper system, cafeteria waste, even the trays and silverware, which are made from biodegradable material, go into the machine, along with paper waste throughout the school. It's all ground up, processed and dried, and turned into a powdery peat moss-like material that can be used for compost. Compost that can be used in the garden to help provide fresh produce for the school. And for some students, getting that hands-on experience will be a first.
Some of these students here, being in inner city, have not had the opportunity to raise a garden, to know how to plant a seed, to know how to germinate a seed, to actually see a product of what they've actually planted and worked with.
The school also features dashboard technology that will allow students to see in real time exactly how the building systems are performing.
For example, if a student wants to see how the chillers are operating or how much energy they're using, they can simply go and touch that dashboard or the picture of the chiller. It'll come up and tell them how much energy they're using at this particular time. It'll go as far as to tell us which wing of the building is leading in terms of using less energy. And it's really neat. Kids kind of, they do a contest with it, you know. They like to be in first place. Each grade level, they absolutely love that. And that's worked out beautifully for them.
The school cost $23 million to build. But Greg, its energy saving and waste reduction features will continue to save Cabell County money throughout the life of the school. For Environment Matters, I'm Sarah Alford.
Thanks, Sarah. Building to LEED standards can be more expensive up front, but the cost benefits can produce meaningful results at the local level. We sat down recently with the West Virginia School Building Authority Executive Director, Dr. Mark Manchin, to talk about the future of green school building in the state.
The upfront cost is not that dramatically greater, but the savings in energy can be dramatic. 35 to 40%, which is considerable. Now, the school building authority must come up with the upfront money. Then after we fund a project, we move on. But the counties realize those savings, and it is dramatic. As I said earlier, I was superintendent of Webster County in the mid-90s. We put the first geothermal system into Webster County High School. The first geothermal heating system in the state of West Virginia was at Webster County High School. And we, in 1 year, we noticed a nearly 40% savings in the energy cost from the year prior to putting the system in to the next year. We realized that. Now, when money is not necessarily used for energy, then it can be used for the classroom. So there's the benefit is obviously the money's not going to electric bills or gas bills or any other, the water, things of that nature, or heating of the water, that now that money is going to be utilized because there's a finite amount of money. So that money will be used to go directly into the classroom.
The School Building Authority was created by the West Virginia Legislature in 1989 to provide state funds for school construction and maintenance to meet the educational needs efficiently and economically. The crowd was a little thin at this year's DEP Day at the Legislature, due in no small part to the frigid weather. Temperatures in the single digits canceled school and kept the usually bustling crowds home. About 70 DEP employees from 16 different agency divisions were on hand to answer questions from students, tour groups, and legislators about various DEP programs and activities at information booths set up throughout the second floor of the State Capitol building. DEP Day at the Legislature is an annual event. The date for next year's program has not been set. Up next, unfortunately, this is where a lot of used tires in West Virginia end up. But a DEP program is working to change that one truckload at a time. We're back in a moment.